Great here. Welcome to a new game. I decided a while ago that I wanted to play Factorio. And while I have played about 70 hours of the game, I've actually never completed the vanilla game. I never went all the way to what's the end goal of the game. Oops. That's a bit loud. Let's drop that down a bit. There we go. Okay, so if you have not heard of Factorio, it is a game. The basic premise is that you're dumped on a planet by yourself, and you need to launch a satellite for reasons. I would like to think that's like, hey, I'm here, please come rescue me type of thing. To do this, you build a giant factory. It's all about problem solving through automation, pretty much. It's a pretty fun game. It's a sandbox, randomly generated map, which is infinite in all directions. And you just you start off in a very Minecraft way. Yeah, punch wood. So, what I'm gonna do is this is completely vanilla. This is unmodded. I'm familiar with a lot of the mods. I've actually played quite a few runs of modded Factorio, and there's a lot of good mods out there. But I want to do just one run, completely vanilla. And I decided, that would make a good Let's Play. So that's what I'm going to do here. Now, I am going to explain what I'm doing, but this isn't going to be a Factorio tutorial, and also, I've only got about, like I said, 60 to 70 hours into the game. I'm not a Factorio expert. If you're looking for a good tutorial and someone who's actually really good at Factorio and loves the game, I would recommend checking out Arumba's channel. He's got tutorials on multiple versions. He's running a modded Minecraft campaign, and actually a lot of the things that I do were inspired by the videos that he had, so give him a quick gander if you're looking for that experience. Anyway, so at the beginning here, what I'm doing is I'm actually clearing out this iron patch. Iron is one of the most used resources in this game. There's actually four basic resources. There's iron, copper, stone, and oil. And so here is the iron patch that I'm going to work with. If I take a look at the map, over here, this is a stone patch. Oh, I forgot coal. coal for fuel. Here's iron. Here's copper. And then there's a giant oil patch down to the south. So it looks like what I'm going to want to do on this campaign is I'm probably going to run to the west, it looks like. But to do that, I need to just clear out some space. This wood is the early fuel source. And let's get this started. So this is a burner miner. And what this does is it extracts resources out of the ground, whatever it's placed on top of, directly on top of, so only these four squares. And you can see over on the side, it's expected to get 2,500 coal out of this. So what I'm doing is I'm just grabbing coal, and now that I can pull the wood out, throw the coal in there, and that'll keep running. So this is the very, very beginning of the automation, where instead of mining it by hand like this, I'm now going to have miners that actually do this for me, and it drops it into that box over there. Now, the other thing that you might have noticed is that when I go to craft things, I open up my inventory here, and I decide there's these four tabs, and I decide what I want to craft. Now, you notice how this says that it requires four wood, and wood is over here. Now, I don't have to create the intermediate steps. If you watch, what happens is if I'm able to craft the intermediate steps, the game is intelligent enough to queue up each of the steps in line to actually get things running, which is actually pretty nice. However, in the long term, you actually don't want to build too much. I did not mean to do that. You don't want to build too much in hand. You actually want to build up the infrastructure so that things are built for you. Because a lot of things have to get built. Let's see, what do I need? I need iron, it looks like. I'm trying to get another... Yeah, I need more iron. So, let's mine some iron directly. I just wanted to get a good fuel source out of that coal patch. And there goes my first pick, which costs iron, so this is going to take a little bit. The game at the very beginning is pretty slow, but once you start getting the basics of the automation up, it starts the speed starts to pick up quite nicely. Let's see, I actually want to put that there for now. And let's get wood in there to cook up the iron. Most of the resources you'll have to actually process in some manner. Right there. I want to turn on this display. This will show me right here. I'm turning on detailed. This shows me where this is pointing towards with the arrow, and it shows me what's inside this box, which is coal. And down here it's showing me, hey, I'm smelting iron plates in here. In fact, let's get coal in here and keep that running. Now I've got enough for another burner drill. And what I'll do is I'll place this one down and have it output directly into the furnace. And now I don't have to mine the iron anymore. Right, I wanted that. There we go. Okay, so that is going to start producing iron plates for me automatically. Let's take a look over here. So here is one copper patch. I got lots of copper here. And this oil down here is just absolutely glorious. Look at all that oil. So this actually is not the first time that I am starting this campaign. I actually got 7 hours into it yesterday. Before I did a very newbie mistake, yeah, this is where I'm going to put my engines. I made a very newbie mistake. I didn't check my audio on the first, before I started recording. I just presumed everything was running fine because, hey, I've been using this setup for quite a while now. And for some reason, DXStory decided it's not going to record the game sound. So I had 7 hours with just my vocals. Not fun. So I'm restarting. In that campaign, I actually had just gotten to the oil stage, and I had a whole whopping four oil things, oil spots. Just horrible. Okay, so I want another burner miner. Actually, I want two of them. And what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to pick up this box. I'm going to rotate this to the south. And this burner miner here, there it is. I'm going to feed into... Oops. There. So now, this the top burner miner is going to feed into the bottom one, which, when it extracts, is going to feed back into the top one. And they're going to act like chess with each other. So that's a quick way to actually keep this running while working on the stuff down here. Okay, next up is going to be stone, because I need a lot of stone for burners and stone furnaces. because the stone furnaces actually go into the burners. And I don't want to make too many of these. Wait, I still have one more because I was smart. There we go. Okay, so throw that in there. Drop the chest down. I don't want to make too many of these burner miners because they do not upgrade to anything. So this is a resource that I'm not going to be able to use in the long run. The stone furnaces, I can use them in other things. I can eventually get rid of them. There's other stuff that I can make that will eventually upgrade into other things. So while that's working, I'm actually going to... No, I think I'm actually pretty good for the time being. Okay, now, I've opened up my inventory, and this is pretty much everything that I can make right now. And you notice there's no rockets, there's no satellite, there's nothing on here. There's a research panel with a ton of research that you have to go through. So what we need to do is, once we start building up the factory, we are going to have to research, actually go through the tech tree, and as we unlock more technology, we're able to do more and more stuff. So like I said, at the beginning, it's pretty slow because there's actually not a lot that you can do. Probably one of the best things that you can do at the very beginning is chop down trees. Now, the game isn't just running around and just building things. It can be that, but I'm running, like I said, stock vanilla. And one of the things that you can do in stock vanilla, or one of the challenges in stock vanilla, I should say, is there are actually aliens on this planet. And they don't like you. If you get too close to them, they will attack you. And at the moment, you can tell I've only got a tiny little pistol. So, the other thing is, even if you don't get close to them, they'll eventually attack you. Because everything that you do, and if I open up my map, you'll see this red overlay right here. Everything that you do generates pollution. Running burner miners generates pollution. Even if you are... later on, you're running miners that are run off of electricity. The generation of electricity creates pollution. The actual miners create pollution. So, pollution expands out, pisses off the aliens, and they come and try to eat your face. So let's get the copper going. There we go. So right now, there aren't any alien bases in range that I can see. However, once I get outside of this starter zone, that will change, and it will change in a big way. For those who have watched Factorio before, I'm running on the stock default generation, medium everything across the board, just to get this taken care of. Go. Okay, so I am building up a stockpile of iron. I am getting a stockpile of copper up and running. Copper you need a ton of, but not in the early game. You do need enough to run power lines for electricity. However, later on, you have to make these electric circuits, and they require a ton of copper. And these patches, without mods, they do deplete over time. So, like this square right here, if you look over on the side, it says there's 1,205 copper ore in just this square. So, there's quite a bit here, but it'll eventually run out, and that will force me to expand into the alien-held areas. And that's the gist of the game. Like I said, creative problem solving in a sandbox environment. So, now that I have the basics opening up, and I'm just chopping these trees to clear out this patch while my resources build up, my next step is I need to create power generation. Well, my next step is to get another pick. There we go. Early game power generation is through steam engines. You pump water out of a water source, which is over there to the east, into boilers, and then from the boilers into steam engines, and from there, you run the power lines everywhere and power everything. But that requires a lot of iron to actually get up and running. In fact, let's go take a look at that. Let's make sure that this is going to run for a while. Let's just put half into each. There we go. So that'll run for a while. 109 iron plates. We're getting there. Let's get some more coal. Okay. How many boilers can I make? I need 14 boilers and 10 steam engines is the ratio, and that's what I'm shooting for. I also need the pipes to make the connection between the two. So we're just gonna let that run for a bit more. In the meantime, let's get set up with let's get 20 power cables up and running. Like I said, since there's intermediate pieces, it just queues them all up. What I did there is I hit right-click, and that will create 5 at a time. If I left-click, it would do 1 at a time. There we go. And I know this gets pretty dark at night. Eventually, I'll be able to create lights that will light up, lights that'll light up things up. Good. I can definitely English. It'll make it brighter for the videos, but until then, I've got to go with just the flashlight that I've got here. Just plenty of wood. I think this patch is cleared out. Yep. So, what I'm going to want to do is I think I'm going to start everything right here and then head to the west. Because I have this nice clear area in between the forest to the north and to the south. Which will actually help, because the pollution does get absorbed. Grasses absorb pollution, water absorbs pollution, trees absorb it, so I really don't want to chop down more than I need to. Especially early on when I'm very, very vulnerable. Okay, let's get our offshore pump. And now I can make 34 boilers, and I only need 14, so there's 5, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 14 boilers. And then I'm going to want underground pipe. Wait, I'm not going to... Stop. There we go. I actually want 2 sets of underground pipe. The underground pipe, what that does is it moves fluid around, obviously, but what it really does is it lets me walk through the area that the pipe occupies. So, what looks like this would be a good area. Can I walk through here? Yes, I can. So that is something I'm going to have to be aware of. Okay, offshore pump. Goes right here. I want it there. Then I want a max length of underground pipe. This is why I'm doing that, so I can walk through it. Then the 14 engines. And now what I'm going to do is not an underground pipe because I'm going to run into this. That was not a good idea. Yeah, let's just move this down right away. That's part of Factorio is, hey, I need to build it here. Oops. No, I need to build it elsewhere. So let's move it down here. Max length there. Plus my 14 engines. Or boilers, I should say. And then another max length of pipe, and this is where my engines will reside. There we go. More stone. More iron. More fuel. There we go. Okay. Let's get more copper out of here. And just fill them up. Keep that running as much as possible. Can I make my engines? I can make 6. Well, let's get these started. So now, one of the things that I can do is I have... I could run down here and put fuel into these boilers, and doing that by hand would take time, and this is Factorio, you're supposed to automate everything. So how am I going to get the coal from over here to my boilers over here? Well, that's where these things come into play. They are transport belts. Let me create some. Actually, let me put down my engines real quick. 3, 4, 5. And a gap in between. There we go. Okay, so here are the transport belts. What this does is, if I hit my... I can't drop anything. But this moves things. As you can see, I'm actually moving on it. So I can have the burner miners, or any miner really, mine onto a belt, and then bring the coal down here. Then there's these things called inserters. And what they do is they pick up items out of an inventory, such as a chest or, such as a chest, and puts it onto a belt or from a belt into an inventory. So what that means is I can come up here, have the coal deposit onto a belt, run over to the burners, and have inserters put the coal into the burners. And that's how I generate my power. Of course, that's going to take a little bit because I need a lot of iron to generate that much, or to create that much transport belt. So let's just... What I'm doing here is I'm creating a path where I can get my coal all the way over here. I need much more iron. It's mainly the pipes that's doing it. I need one more engine after this. Oops. I thought I put a gap in between them. I guess I didn't. There's the gap. 1, 2, 3, 4. Guess I should have said mind the gap. I need 20 plate. Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to finish out that last engine, and I'm going to put a cut in here, and in the meantime, also finish up that last engine. When we come back, I'll get power generation up and running, and then hopefully the basics of my science system. And that will be that. I hope you enjoyed today's video, and I'll see you next time. Have fun.